The Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1886, Grouping and Sorting Power Pivot Dates. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. In the past, back in version 1 of Power Pivot, I talked about the fact that you cannot group dates that you run through Power Pivot. So here we have a date field. If I would add this to the data model, and then create a pivot table and put dates along the left-hand side and revenue in the values area, you'll see that there is no way on the Analyze or in Excel 2010, the Options tab, to group that field, to group the daily dates up to months, quarters, and years. So we have to do this ourselves, and we do this through something called a calendar table. I'm going to take column C, our date column, and copy that, Control-C. I'll create a new worksheet and paste. Control V. I want to remove duplicates. I need just a perfect unique data set here. So we'll go to Data, Remove Duplicates, click OK. And then we're going to add our own grouping field. So we'll have year, MonthNum, and MonthName. I'm going to add month number even if I don't need it. So this is just straight Excel, right? So equal year of A2, equal month of A2, and out here I would use equal text of that date, comma. I'm going to use just 3 digits, so MMM in quotes. All right, so there's our formulas. You could, of course, add new columns for quarter if you wanted to group by quarter, or even week if you wanted to group by week. So we add all of this data to our table. Now let's make it into a table with Control T. My table has headers. You don't have to rename it, but I'm going to call it Cal. And we will add this to our Power Pivot model. So you see we now have two worksheets, Table 1 and Cal. We need to create a relationship between those two. So I come back to Table 1 and I click on the date field, and under Design we will create a relationship from Table 1 date to Calendar date. Click Create. Simple enough. I'm also going to come to the Calendar table, and on the Design tab, choose Mark as Date Table. One more thing I'm going to do back on the Home tab, here under Month Name. Now, one problem that we have in Power Pivot is that month names are not sorted according to the custom list. They're sorted alphabetically, so April 1st and then August. I'm going to say that I want to sort this column by the month number column. So even though I never intended to put the month number in the pivot table, by adding that extra step, I'm now able to have the month names sort correctly. Let's go back to Excel, go to our pivot table, and I will remove this date from the table, and from my calendar table, I'm going to add year going across and month name going down. You'll see that I now have the month sorted properly and the years going across. Certainly a lot easier to do this in regular Excel with just group field, right? Group by month, group by year, and you can drag the fields across. But it is possible to do that in Power Pivot using
Mr. Excel's got bills like you. Here's a product placement you gotta sit through.
Hey, just a quick product note here. Rob Collian and my new book, Power Pivot Alchemy, is now out. It's available at MrExcel.com, Amazon.com, or anywhere you want to go. Lots of great patterns and techniques for using Power Pivot in Excel. All right, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.